years had clearly shown that there was a video, audio and electronic evidence was there. Now, sitting over here, I do not know whether the NIA had really brought it to the notice of the Supreme Court that such evidence exists, audio and video, wherein four conspiracy meetings were held from 2008, January 2008, till the blast of Malegaon. And in all those meetings, Mr. Purohit was present. Now, I don't know whether the Supreme Court has even taken notice of that sitting over here. But as far as I'm concerned, there is a very strong concrete evidence against Mr. Purohit that he was involved in that Malegaon blast. And please also remember that it is not the duty of an military intelligence officer to investigate in internal affairs of our country. No military intelligence officer has any right whatsoever, neither it is there in their charter of duty, that they will investigate in internal matters of country. That is for the IB to do and for the local CID to do. Third point, no military intelligence officer has any role whatsoever in handling explosive substance. And fourthly, Supreme Court has given a bail, the court has not exonerated him. And please, last point is that, please this, look at it in larger picture. Since 2014, since Mr. Modi has become the Prime Minister and BJP has come in power, you are seeing pattern of these cases where the Hindutva alleged accused are involved, the cases are dropping. So this is what I have to say.
But sir, the question here is about him being in jail for 9 years, charges not being framed against him. Do you not feel that under these circumstances he deserved a bail at least?
Well, bail is a right in our country. What about bail to the Muslim Dalits and tribals? Who are nearly our Indian jails are filled with Dalits, Muslims and tribals. What about bail to them?
Exactly. Since you speak about bail in those cases, similar principle applies here as well.
Well, that's why I've said I don't know whether the NIA had brought to the notice of the court that Mr. Purohit had attended four conspiracy meetings. And after those four meetings, the Malegaon blast took place. So his contention that he was a mole is obnoxious because military intelligence does not interfere in the internal matters of our country. Having said so, the court has given him a bail. I don't know whether the NIA or the court have taken notice of that, because that will only come when the final order comes. Sitting over here, I cannot comment on that.
So one more question about him being a military mole.
Let me answer that question by saying, if Hemant Karkare was alive today, what would you have asked him? Because it is the investigation of Hemant Karkare. Please do not forget Hemant Karkare, the great martyr of our nation, who had unearthed all these elements. Well, I believe that terror should not be looked through the prism of any religion. Terror exists and people use religion to further their majoritarian or their obnoxious views.
Sir, the statement that you made.
If we can recall, sir, Rohini Salyan, the public prosecutor, former public prosecutor, had pointed out and had said that she was facing pressure from NIA on this particular Malegaon blast investigation, sir. How you see
I am not at all surprised. Rohini Salyan was absolutely right. She had even given proof of that officer who had pressurized her. And I am saying that please look at it in a larger picture. Since 2014, all these terrorism cases related to alleged Hindutva people are falling like a pack of cards. Now, whether it is Makkah Masjid, Asim Anand got bail, the accused got bail, the government did not appeal against that bail order. He was, Asim Anand was discharged in the Ajmer blast. The Modi government, the NIA does not want to appeal against it. So there is a general pattern in all these cases.
How you see, sir, Harish Salve, senior advocate Harish Salve, securing bail for Sadhvi Pragya, now Colonel Poo, his earlier also?
Well, Harish Salve is a lawyer, but what Harish Salve has said that whenever investigation starts, political messages, political messages go around. Let me add, no, why only political, even religious? Has the media talked about those boys in Hyderabad 2002, that suicide blast, 15 years, 11 years, 8 months they lost? Now you are glorifying his bail. Please don't do it. He's still in LH, accused in this case. There is nothing great about this man. He's only out on bail and he's facing a grievous charge of terrorism. He's still an accused in this case. There is nothing great about this man. And he himself has dug a big hole for himself by saying that he was a mole. How can an intra-intelligence be a mole in an internal matters?
So how do you explain the army not taking action against him?
How do I explain Machil encounter, people getting bail? How do I explain Patribal encounter, accused going scot-free? I cannot explain. These are so many questions which are there right in front of the nation.
Sir, I'm asking this question because Republic TV has access to the army correspondents which accepted that they were aware of his mole activities.
How can a military intelligence officer investigate in internal matters of a country? If that is the case, then this nation will become like Pakistan, God forbid. Military has no role whatsoever in our internal matters, and that too, military intelligence cannot investigate in our internal matters. This is a democratic, secular, federal country, and the army works under civilian leadership. The army cannot do whatever it wants. It has to work under civil leadership, and a military intelligence cannot investigate. And Mr. Prohit himself has claimed that he was a mole. He infiltrated Abhinav Bharat. How can he do it? How can he do it? That is not the work of military intelligence.
Also, sir, adding a point in this, Home Minister of the country had also in Parliament said that there is no saffron terror. So that's why particularly BJP and affiliated parties, they are claiming and seeing this bail as a victory of their claims.
Bail cannot be a victory. Bail cannot be a victory at all. I would tell all these people to read page number 69 of the charge sheet that was filed by ETS. And please do not forget, if you are casting aspersions on anyone, you are casting aspersions on Hemant Karkare, who laid down his life for this nation.
Sir, I just want to ask supplementary to that, the ATS charge sheet is there, but the NIA charge sheet actually says everything in opposition to the ATS charge sheet.
NIA did not file a charge sheet, NIA did investigation.
Yes, their investigation says.
Which is the charge sheet of NIA, so please get your facts right.
Sir, can I just ask you one question, though?
Investigation that is hinting at, do you see political influence coming in the investigations?
Why didn't this government appeal against the bail given to Makkah Masjid accused? 90 days they should have done it. Why didn't this government appeal against Asim Anand's acquittal in the Ajmer blast? These are all patterns, isn't it? Because if BJP was not in power and those accused were happened to be Muslim, you would have called it minority appeasement. I am saying that these are all terrorist cases. Please do not look at them through the prism of your narrow ideology. This has to be dealt in a very straightforward and in a very strong way. Because God forbid this might come to haunt us in the future. Okay, sir.
Also said what you have said. You support his comment.
I do not know what Digvijay has said. I am not his spokesperson. You please go and ask him. I can speak for myself.
Hindi mein kar lete, sir. Sir, Kanan Purohit ko bail mil gayi hai. Uske upar aapka kya reaction?
मेरा रिएक्शन ये है कि मुझे यहाँ पर बैठकर मैं ये नहीं बता सकता कि एनआईए ने सुप्रीम कोर्ट को ये बात बताया नहीं बताया कि चार एटीएस की चार्जशीट पेज नंबर 69 में कर्नल पुरोहित के खिलाफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ऑडियो वीडियो एविडेंस है। अब नहीं मालूम कि या उन्हें बताया या सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उसको नोटिस लिया भी या नहीं लिया, मगर ये बात बिल्कुल सही है कि कर्नल पुरोहित चारों कॉन्स्पिरेसी मीटिंग्स में मौजूद थे और उन मीटिंग्स के पहली मीटिंग के होने के 8 महीने के बाद मालेगांव का ब्लास्ट हुआ। दूसरी बात यह है कि मिलिट्री इंटेलिजेंस की कोई अख्तियार नहीं है कि हिंदुस्तान के हमारे वतन अजीज के अंदरूनी मामलात में इन्वेस्टिगेशन करे, उनको अख्तियार ही नहीं है। तीसरा, अगर ये हुआ है तो फिर इसका जिम्मेदार कौन है। पांचवी बात यह है कि मालेगांव के, फिर आप एक बात को याद रखिए कि आज ये जो एटीएस की चार्जशीट तैयार की गई थी वो हेमंत करकरे की तरफ से तैयार की गई थी, तो अगर कोई आज इस पर सवालिया निशान उठा रहा है तो वो मुझ पर नहीं बल्कि हेमंत करकरे की ईमानदारी पर, उनकी वफादारी पर और उनकी कुर्बानी पर सवाल उठा रहा है।
सर, यू वर सेइंग, वन सेकंड, यू वर सेइंग दैट देयर इज नो सप्लीमेंट्री चार्ज शीट बाय द एनआईए। सर, आई हैव इट विद मी, आई जस्ट वांट टू शेयर विद यू।
सप्लीमेंट्री इज डिफरेंट,
बट इट्स अ चार्ज शीट।
सप्लीमेंट्री,
सो आई जस्ट वांट टू करेक्ट यू ऑन दैट।
नो, सप्लीमेंट्री,
एंड दे हैव अपोज्ड एवरीथिंग दैट द एटीएस हैज सेड।
दैट इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, दिस इज अ लार्जर पैटर्न।
There is
a larger pattern, you have to read to it. From 2014, since the government has come into power, why haven't they appealed against Asiman Nakul Hospital? Why haven't, what did Rohini Salian said, was it false? Thirdly, Makkah Masjid blast, accused get bail, you don't appeal. What are these?
Sir, Rohini Salian ke comment ko kaise dekhte hain?
Rohini Salian ne sachchai kahi thi। रोहिणी सालिया ने यह बात कही थी कि उन्होंने वो भी बताया कि कौन सा ऑफिसर था एनआईए का जो उन पर दबाव डाल रहा था, केस बता मत जाइए। भाई अगर आज आप ये सब चीजों को इस तरह से देख रहे हैं तो फिर आप हेमंत करकरे को क्या जवाब देंगे? हेमंत करकरे ने ये सब इन्वेस्टिगेशन किया, इतनी बड़ी कुर्बानी उन्होंने मुल्क के लिए दी। आज आप ठीक है, आपकी नजर में मेरा ये बोलना आपके लिए बड़ी तकलीफ भी होगा, रात की नींद हराम हो जाएगी, पेट में दर्द होगा, मगर हेमंत करकरे को क्या कहेंगे आप? उनकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन था। और याद रखिए, मिलिट्री इंटेलिजेंस को कोई अख्तियार नहीं है हमारे अंदरूनी मामलात में इन्वेस्टिगेशन करने का। ये आईबी का काम है, स्टेट सीआईडी का काम है, मिलिट्री इंटेलिजेंस का काम नहीं। ना मिलिट्री इंटेलिजेंस के पास एक्सप्लोसिव होता है, कौन रखता है एक्सप्लोसिव इंटेलिजेंस के पास? ये तो दूसरे डिपार्टमेंट का काम।
सर, यू फील देयर आर रिपोर्ट्स दैट ही हैज बीन टॉर्चर्ड एक्सटेंसिवली इन कस्टडी, हाउ डू यू एक्सप्लेन दैट एंड व्हाट वुड यू से अबाउट दैट?
वुड यू डू अ प्रोग्राम ऑन टॉर्चर ऑफ मुस्लिम बॉयज?
एब्सोल्युटली,
डू इट एंड देन आस्क मी दिस क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज़ यू बॉयज हु आर अरेस्टेड इन मक्का मस्जिद, लिसन टू मी, 879 मुस्लिम बॉयज वर टॉर्चर्ड इन मक्का मस्जिद ब्लास्ट एंड वी फोर्स द गवर्नमेंट टू पे देम कंपनसेशन। Take the example of Malegaon, 5 years they were tortured. Look at the one person who was acquitted in the Mumbai train blast. Read his book, the way he was tortured, how in front of him he was told that his wife will be disrobed. If torture has been done, then torture has to be looked into from both the sides, not from one side. And please stop glorifying an accused who's still an accused, who he has only got a bail, and don't glorify. Thank